Hi, I'm Chad Wahlquist. I'm here today to talk to the head of our construction and utilities pod, Tristan. Tristan, thanks for joining me.
Chad, it's great to be here.
Yeah.
Thanks for having me in the studio.
The Arkansas studio has become. So maybe you could start off with tell us a little bit about how you joined Palantir and then maybe your background here.
Yeah, so I'm closing in on 5 years at Palantir, joined just before COVID, which sort of set in motion my path at Palantir. Worked on a lot of emergency response during 2020. Did some supply chain workflows for the COVID PPE supply chain, and then started working in utilities and have been there for the last 4 years.
Yeah, well, 5 years around Palantir is actually probably a pretty long time, so that's awesome. What was your background?
So I have a background in data analytics and sort of business and math at the same time.
Yeah.
So was in applied data analytics for a startup for 4 years beforehand, sort of experienced all the growing pains of establishing a stack with a lot of different pieces.
Yep.
When I joined Palantir and I saw the platform for the first time, I was like, where was this for the last 4 years?
When I
was building on Redshift.
Here. Yeah. So you've been here a while, but your background was data analytics. How did you end up in really the construction and utility space?
So very typical, I think, Palantir story where we went where we were needed. So we started in 2020 working with PG&E and to become sort of the digital backbone for all of the operational turnaround. Worked on that project in a variety of different roles and then started our work with SoCal Edison, Southern California Edison, putting in place a lot of similar wildfire mitigation practices that we had established as best practice in the Bay Area. And then around 2021, with a couple other Palantirians, we saw sort of a need to bring these same platforms to the rest of the industry and sort of have grown our practice tenfold since.
Yeah.
And yet we're barely scratching the surface. There's a lot more that we can do with each utility, and there's a lot more utilities that have yet to work with us. I believe it's really important that we work with all utilities in the US, that we build a really, really valuable product for them so that they run more efficiently, because all of the economy is downstream of utilities. And so if we can help them operate more efficiently, increase the capacity on the grid, build more efficiently, be more productive, it has ripple effects across the economy.
Yeah, I love, it comes back to the overall mission of how are we really going to reindustrialize, the U.S.? It starts upstream with having the power to be able to do these things, to power the AI, to do the, to do the reindustrialization, to build the other things. That's all based on this, which is that overall mission of Palantir. And I love that you've got this big section right in the middle that you're helping drive. That's pretty cool.
And it's really three things today. It's how do you build more capacity through construction much more effectively? Second is how do you upgrade the current infrastructure by spending every dollar more wisely in a more targeted way? And then third is operating the current state of the grid in the most reliable way.
So we've been talking a lot about the ontology. Why is it valuable for utilities?
For utilities, the ontology enables the organization to look at the infrastructure, the assets on the infrastructure, the work that's been done on the infrastructure, the risk surrounding the infrastructure, whether that's weather, environmental risk from proximity of trees. Believe it or not, it's really hard to actually see all of these things and then be able to orchestrate decisions in real time on top of it. And that's very extensible. You can bring in your SCADA system and then look at telemetry. Visibility into this ontology can support workflows across the organization, whether you're managing outages, whether you're managing communications with customers, or you're managing how to upgrade the infrastructure.
Yeah, that's fascinating. The ontology really is the core of how you model how the world really is, not in a system language for a report. I think that's a differentiator from a lot of things, and people don't understand that the power of the ontology is because you're modeling that ground truth that then enables all of these other use cases, these other things.
And along the way, we have to deal with bad data and imperfect data, right?
Yeah.
But having the ontology gives us more information to work with. So we can sort of fill in the blanks sometimes because we have information geospatially that enables us to infer what a missing data point could be. Or we can reconcile different systems. For example, a common thing is SAP will have a record of the installation of a pole in the field, but another system will have the record of the retrieval of that pole in the field. So if you only look at SAP, you think that there's all these ghost poles in the field, but they're not there anymore. So having the visibility across these enterprise systems is actually really hard for utilities and extremely differentiated.
So one of the hardest things about new technology is actually the people, the change management. So what does user adoption look like?
Well, in those high stress, high consequence environments, the bar is very binary. It either works and it works better than anything established, or it doesn't work. And that's the bar that we hold ourselves to. So every use case we put out to production has to meet that bar. Now, these use cases are so valuable in the day-to-day life of our users that they're the ones creating the waterfall of use cases that influences the roadmap. So a customer like PG&E that has been with us for 5 years, close to 5 years, has more than 100 use cases in production. Another one of our flagship utilities customers in the Pacific Northwest has put 30 use cases in production in their first 12 months with us.
Wow. Wow. That's pretty impressive. There's a lot going on in the utility space. Like, what's the impact? What are we doing?
Utilities are at the center of a lot of trends in our society, right? Yep. And so our role in this industry is really upstream of the whole economy. And that's why we started working on transmission construction. And our pod is spanning utilities and construction because we were exposed to that problem space coming out of utilities.
Yeah, that's very cool.
And in the last 2 years with large language models, we've seen the construction industry become a really important vertical for us. LLMs are particularly applicable for them because the whole industry runs on documents, PDFs. So AIP has been really, really levered in helping get this information into the ontology, having those documents talk to each other through the ontology network. And so we're seeing use cases across the lifecycle of construction that are leveraging AI.
Wow. So it's not just, oh, I'm going to extract some information using OCR. It's really understanding what's in those documents, ontologizing the relationships between things that is unlocking the value. So then, like, once you have that, like, what are people doing with it? So I got all this unstructured data, now I have access to it. Like, what's the use case that people then leverage with that?
It's really two things. It's getting the data out of these unstructured data formats and then automating the processes that rely on them. Whether it's automatically sourcing the best supplier, negotiating quotes down, producing quotes, producing engineering documents with AI, always with a human in the loop approach. It spans the whole life cycle.
Yeah, you bring up a point because I hear a lot of times like, oh, my data's not ready for AI. But I would argue, and it sounds like you're making that same argument, is actually that's the perfect time to use generative AI and AIP is to actually make sense of these things because you can start to infer and fill in gaps.
I think there's a lot of paralysis because of bad data, right? Yeah. And I think the first step is understanding what's actually bad, and the ontology is able to shine a really bright spotlight on the gaps and the bad data.
Yeah.
And then you can actually have a plan of action to help improve the quality of your data.
Yeah, there's no better way than trying to actually use it to figure out what's wrong with it.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's cool.
The construction industry is really interesting from that perspective because there are notorious laggards in tech adoption, and they've for the most part, haven't jumped onto the data warehouse, data lakehouse cycle of analytics.
Oh, really?
And LLMs and the current cycle is a great way to catch up and shortcut all of that and not have to invest in a data warehouse, a data lakehouse, but immediately go into operational use cases that are applicable to the construction industry, whether that's estimating the cost of a project, scheduling, managing suppliers and subcontractors.
Well, I learned a lot today, like the importance of utilities and not only playing like what I'm interested in with AI, but just a part of our whole country, our daily lives. It's really critical. And I love that we're using AI to help the utilities be more efficient, to help make sure we have the power for everything else we need. So thanks for making the trip.
Thank you for having me. It was a pleasure.
Yeah, it's a great conversation.
Likewise.